everyone, and welcome to our latest edition of the NLP stream, which is a weekly series dedicated to the latest and greatest in natural language processing. I am your host, as usual, Brian Munns. I'm product manager and developer experience manager at Expert AI, the leaders in NLP technology. And today we have a really interesting topic talking about the WebCrow AI project, which is one which uses AI to solve crossword puzzles. And it's just gonna be a really interesting one, and I wanna get right into it because there's a lot to talk about. And so our special guest today is Giovanni Angelini. And we're gonna start actually with a video which kind of gives an overview of the WebCrow project, and then Giovanni's gonna get right into it. So we could follow that video.
Hi to everybody. Hi, everybody. So I'm Giovanni Angelini. Let me share my slides that I'm going to use for presenting my share screen here window for. Okay, I hope this is. Is this correct? No. Stop sharing, share again. I've done this before. Okay. 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 Here I am. Okay. Let me introduce myself. I'm Giovanni Angelini. I work in Expert AI in a group called Hybrid Language Technology, which is doing research and development for Expert AI. I work in this project, WebCrow 2.0, with different members coming from Expert AI, like Marco Ernandes, which unfortunately is not here, Andrea Zugarini, and Tommaso Iaquinta, and some professor from the University of Siena. What's WebCrow deals with? Well, actually, the question is...
I think you might be sharing the wrong screen, actually.
Okay, stop. Sorry about this.
For their monitor, yeah, sorry.
Okay. I went your computer. I've done this before. Why? Okay.
I think that's one.
Okay, so let's go back again. Sorry about this delay. I'm Giovanni Angelini, I work in Expert AI in the Hybrid Language Technology Research and Development Group. So we're going to talk about WebCrow 2.0. So this is a second version of WebCrow, which started time ago in the University of Siena, and now we are presenting a second version of WebCrow, which is a work which is brought through the University of Siena and Expert AI. What the question we are trying to solve in this project is, can machine actually solve crosswords puzzles? Crosswords puzzles, actually, it's something that it's not new for us in human beings, because we are solving them since last century. And what makes them so interesting is that actually it's not always the same. It's kind of complex, and this complexity comes out from language. So actually what we have to do is we have to deal with language, which is not the same thing has happened in previous challenges. For example, we have AI have actually in his history have other challenges with humans, machine against human, like with chess. In the case of chess, we have a domain which have strict rules it's a strict domain, while this is it's an open domain because it has to do with language. Here we have two examples of crosswords which were presented to human beings more than 100 years ago. One is the Italian crossword, and one is the an English crossword, which came out in 1913 in the New York World magazine. Since then, we have published thousands and thousands of crosswords. What makes it difficult for AI is actually that we are managing language. Language is not a closed domain situation like chess, but it's an open domain, and it has its complexity, as we have to understand its semantics in what it's in its meaning. So let's go and see what actually WebCrow uses to manage crossword solving. I would like to highlight that we have three main things that we have to keep in account when solving crossword. The first thing is that we have to understand the clues, which means to read the clues. For human beings, obviously, this is quite straightforward, but for machine, it means to understand what the meaning inside the clues, the language which is used, the concept which actually are inside the clues. Then we have to actually make use of different pieces of knowledge, not just one kind of knowledge, but different ways of trying to find an answer to the clue. So we start from the clue, and then making some linguistic and logic steps, we try to find a way to find a candidate answer for that clue. That answer has to be put in a grid. So what we would like to show is that for solving crossword, we actually need a combination of tools, of techniques, which came from AI, from natural language processing, machine learning, and also constraint satisfaction. Constraint satisfaction, it's part of solving crossword rules, as we have to, each puzzle contains different answers, and each answer has to actually be, it should match both the across and down answers in the grid. What kind of knowledge we actually use for solving crossword clues? Let me show you three kind of knowledge we actually make use in WebCrow. The first one is a knowledge coming from ontology and lexicon. In this case, WebCrow makes use of expert AI knowledge graph, which is much more than a dictionary. We have different concepts which are related with each other through relationship, and each concept actually has different information, like which words we can use to say that concept, with kind of grammatical role they have, and what actually is the meaning of that concept. Then we need somehow an encyclopedia knowledge, which is knowledge coming from human. And nowadays, and also when WebCrow project started, actually we found that the web, it's a vast and continuously updating collection of human knowledge, which means that basically, if we're talking about a film, or we're talking about a person or someone in a history, we can find about something about this concepts inside the web. Obviously, the hard part is actually trying to find it using the words inside the clues. And then last but not least, one of the things we use for solving crosswords is using knowledge which comes from crossword puzzles, which means that basically what we do is what also human does. The first time you solve a crossword puzzles, you actually have to learn how solving crossword puzzles works. So you have to understand the logics. Once you solve some crossword puzzles, you actually get some knowledge from crossword puzzles previously seen, which means that if you already seen a similar clue or a similar definition, you actually can try to use the knowledge you achieve by solving crossword puzzles with new puzzles. And that's basically what also WebCrow does. For solving puzzles, we mainly go through three steps. The first steps, it's the clue answering step. We have clue answering experts, which actually have a goal, which is produce a list of candidate answer for each clue, which means it has to understand the clue and use some pieces of knowledge and some its expertise, which means also AI tools for NLP tools to answer the clue. There are also some modules which actually are in charge of analyzing the clues in order to know what kind of answer we should expect. We will see this later, what it means. And then each list has to be evaluated, eventually enriched, with two main goals. The first one is that basically, very true for machine, we cannot afford, or at least we have to try to not missing a correct answer in a list, which means we have very long list of candidate answer. But what the second goal is that we have to have on top of this list the correct answer. And this is something very, very important. In this new version of WebCrow, what we have done, we have changed architecture. And we put an architecture which enables other expert modules to give their contribution to WebCrow. So basically, WebCrow sends some messages throughout Redis, a Redis channel, and expect that some experts can solve or give their contribution and giving some answers to some for on some clues using its abilities. So nowadays we have a technology which is open to other external contributions. The second step is basically once we have a list of candidate answer for each clue, what we are going to use is the concept that we have to fill in a puzzle. A puzzle grid, and we have some constraints. So we use the list in order to propagate the probabilities of each list to the other list, which are near or have some constraint with the slots in the grid. We will see this a little bit better. Moreover. And for third thing, once we have done this belief propagation, we are going to fill in the grid. It's a little bit different from human beings. Human beings usually start answering the clues, put in the solution inside the grid. And instead, we have to, and machine has to think about it before filling the grid. So let me show you some example, which will explain the concepts and the ideas that I showed before. Here we have a puzzle, and I highlighted some slots. And for example, we have one across, supportive kind of column, three down, sick. And then we have 25 across Emilia Jones best picture winner. And then we have 14 down cylindrical storage vessels. And then another clue, which is the 46 down, which is drive dot dot dot. Let's go through these. The first definition I would like to talk about is the one across supportive kind of column. So this is a clue which actually it fits better with the knowledge coming from ontology and lexicon. Let's see why. So the solution, the answer, the correct answer to this definition is spinal, because it's something which is connected to column and to the fact that we is something which is support. In expert AI. Knowledge graph, we can actually find two kind of concepts. The first one is column in zoology, which is something which belongs to plants and animals. And the second one, it's spinal column, which is related to column as a specification of column, a hyponym of column. It's a backbone which enabled animals to go on with their muscles in like human beings, like cats and dogs. And so using a knowledge graph is possible to grab this information and put it inside a candidate list in the top of the list as if spinal column is very close to column and also to the fact that it's something which supports human beings and invertebrates to actually walk around. the other definition or clue I would like to show, it's a much more easy definition, which is that three down is sick. What we are trying to find here is a concept which is strictly related to sick. And basically, this relation is very, very strict in, as we can see in the knowledge graph, sick is, it's a synonym of ill. And basically, this is the solution of this clue. And this is, we can find this situation in many other clues in crosswords, and the knowledge graph obviously can grab this information very straightforward. Let's go to another definition, to another clue, which is a definition which needs some encyclopedia knowledge. Here we're talking about a film, a best picture, who won something and was done by or is connected to Emilia Jones. Here, what WebCrow usually does in some of web search model, it goes and try to search for some information related to this clue. Go find a website which talks about Emilia Jones, about best picture, about winning something, and find out that actually coda could be a good answer to this clue definition. Be aware, it's not as easy as it seems. Here we need some NLP to understand the clue. We need an NLP to go through the website language and extract actually what we're looking for. And we are looking for something, a proper noun, which is coda, and which is the title of this film made by Emilia Jones. So basically, we need some NLP technology to actually grab this information and put it on top of the list. Then let's go to knowledge, which comes from puzzles. In this case, we have this definition, 14 down, cylindrical storage vessels. Probably some of you already know solution of this, the answer to this clue, and it's actually silos. In silos, actually, it's an answer to other clues that in previously seen crosswords, like tower for storing grain, where to store grain, cylindrical buildings, and so on. What actually we do here, what WebCrow does here, is to actually manage the clues and the answer I've previously seen crosswords. It needs NLP techniques to actually match the clue in the new crossword and try to see which is the best fit. And here we actually make use also of word embeddings. We make use also of neural ranking, so AI technology, in order to, we are not making an exact match. What we're trying to do is a fuzzy and a smart match with the knowledge which comes out from previously seen crosswords and the new clues we find in crosswords. Sometimes it's good, like in this case, some other times it's not as good as at sea. Here is another clue which I would say, which it shows how clues which are typical of American crosswords. We have what we call fill in a blank. So we have a word we have to put after drive in order to find the correct answer of this clue. This also happens in Italian. Let me show you what in Italian happens. We actually, I don't know, this is obviously an Italian clue, but let me explain you in English what we do in WebCrow. So this is a definition like in which we're looking for something which is not in the web, not in a knowledge graph, not even in previously seen crosswords clues, but it's basically in this definition, we're looking something which is inside a word in the clue. It's in Italian, let's say it's sort of, if I would say that in English, it's something like, say, a little bit of this word. So the word is ebro, and we're taking the first two letters of this word. Or other definition which are what we call rule based, or like in the middle of ball. It's not actually what we're looking for, something which is in the middle of the ball, but we actually are looking something which is inside that word. So we're quickly running out of time. So let me show you what are the goals of the next step, which has much more to do with constraint satisfaction. So we have a candidate answer list. We have different lists which are ranked by probability. We have the constraints. What we are trying to do is to maximize the probability of the chosen answer. So there are different ways in which we can fill in the grid. Basically, we could also choose a letter for each blank cell. But basically, we know this is not good. What we have to choose is that if is our answer which fill in the grid across and down, and we have to take care about the constraints. So what we do is we have some, like here in the right. On the right part of the screen, we see that silos is on top, and here we have a very strong candidate answer. And while we have other lists like in setups where the correct answer is very low, so we basically propagate the probabilities in order to keep into account how the constraints, trying to hire as to score make the idea is that the score should go up for if it fills well the constraints. And then the two goals is obviously to increase the correct answer based on the constraints, and then to make the system robust to missing answers. Let me show you very quickly the idea. The idea is that we have different probabilities. The red one means that I didn't WebCrow was not able to find the answer in of the clue, and then we have very strong answers in some list, and this propagates the probability. So it managed to higher up the score of many lists which are around the list which strong candidate answers. Let's go through this a little bit quicker. And we have to fill in the grid. And nowadays, WebCrow fills in the grid by calculating the probability of each letter. And then this enables us to have even a much more stronger probability set, probability score for each candidate answer and for each letter. Let's go to the last part of my the project. What we're doing in the next months, we are actually trying to challenge humans. We're going to do this at our international conference, WCCI conference in 2002, which is in Padova. We will have two different kind of crosswords languages, which is Italian and English language language crosswords puzzles in Italian and in English, American crosswords. These crosswords will be given to by two different editors. One is an Italian editors, another one is an American editors. And we will try to challenge competitors both on site and both online using a challenging platform, which basically it's the one who will it's not a WebCrow challenging platform, so basically it will be a fair challenge, and we will actually give some special prizes and some gadgets who will compete and during this competition on July. It's the 20th of July. And well, what I would like to say is that actually Italian crossword and American crossword differ. So there are many things which make the two crossword different. Although this, the overall structure of WebCrow can manage to solve both Italian and American crossword. We are also trying to extend WebCrow in order to solve other crosswords in other languages like French, and we hope to do this soon. So I think we've run out of time.
Great. No, thanks. That was actually very, very interesting. Yeah, I mean, I know I have questions, but we're out of time. So if anyone has any questions, put them, you know, you can put them wherever you're watching this. And I'd like to thank Giovanni for presenting, because this is a very interesting subject that isn't kind of off the beaten path a bit. So thanks again for coming and presenting. And of course, I'd like to plug that you should check out the WebCrow project, as well as go to our try site, our demo site for our APIs that have NLP NLU capabilities. You can try them out yourself. But yeah, thanks everyone for tuning in. Again, if you have any questions, leave comments below. And please join us for next week, which is when someone from Accenture is going to talk about reducing operational costs with a content recognition center of excellence. So till then, I will see you next week. Thanks.